मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, क्लास 12th, फर्स्ट चैप्टर ऑफ अलजेब्रा मैट्रिक्स एंड नेक्स्ट टॉपिक इज मल्टीप्लिकेशन ऑफ अ मैट्रिक्स बाय अ स्केलर और स्केलर मल्टीप्लिकेशन। सो स्केलर मल्टीप्लिकेशन विथ एनी गिवन मैट्रिक्स देन लेट A is equals to Aij be the matrix of order m cross n and K be the given scalar, then Ka is known as scalar multiplication with given matrix A. What is the scalar multiplication? We have given one matrix having element in compact form Aij, whose order is m cross n, that is number of rows are n and the number of column are n, and Kb any given scalar. Kb any given scalar means Kb any real number, then Ka, that is multiplication of K with A, where A is the given matrix of order m cross n, is known as scalar multiplication with given matrix A or multiplication of a matrix by a scalar. For example, let the given matrix A is having the element 1, 2, 0, 3, 4, minus 2 of the order 2 cross 3, and let the scalar K is equals to 3, then the scalar multiplication of the given matrix A will be 3A, and it will be equals to 3 into the given matrix 1, 2, 0, 3, 4, minus 2. Now, if any scalar is multiplied with the given matrix, then this scalar will be multiplied with every element of the given matrix. So, it will be equals to 3 will be multiplied with every element. So, 3 into 1, 3, 3 into 2, 6, 3 into 0, 0, 3 into 3, 9, 3 into 4, 12, and 3 into minus 2, that is minus 6. So, this is called scalar multiplication of the matrix. And in general, what you have to learn, when any scalar is multiplied with the given matrix, then that scalar will be multiplied with every element of the given matrix. Now, we will discuss some properties of the scalar multiplication with given matrix A. So, let's say there is a matrix A in compact form Aij of order m cross n, and there are two scalar, one is K and another is L, then the scalar multiplication of K plus L with the given matrix A will be equals to Ka plus LA. Second one is, if there are two matrix, like one matrix is Aij of order m cross n, and another matrix, that is B, Bij of the same order of order m cross n, then if we have to multiply the scalar with the sum of given matrix A plus B, then it will be equals to Ka plus Kb. Similarly, if we have to multiply the scalar KL into given matrix, then we can write it as KA into L or LA into of K or A into KL. And the next one, if there is any negative scalar, let us suppose minus K, if multiplied with the given matrix, then it will be equals to K of A with the scalar minus or minus of K into A. Similarly, if any matrix is multiplied with any scalar, positive scalar A, then it will be equals to A, or if any matrix A is multiplied with the scalar minus 1, then it will be equals to of minus of A. So these are the some properties based on the multiplication of any scalar with the given matrix or scalar multiplication. Now next topic, subtraction of two matrices. Subtraction of matrices. Let A is equals to Aij be the order of m cross n, and B is equals to Bij of the order m cross n be the two given matrix. First matrix A of order m cross n in compact form, the element are Aij, and second matrix B in compact form having element Bij of the same order m cross n. Then subtraction of A from B is represented by A minus B, and A minus B is known as subtraction of matrix A and B, and it will be equals to Aij of order m cross n minus of Bij of order m cross n. Similarly, if we have to find B minus A, then here we will write first given matrix Bij of order m cross n minus of Aij of order m cross n. So the subtraction of matrix, simply whatever the matrix are given, if we have given matrix A and B, and if we have to find A minus B, then the element of the matrix B will be subtracted from the element of matrix A, and if we have to find B minus A, then the elements of matrix A will be subtracted from the element of matrix B. And here subtraction of element means we will subtract the corresponding element, that is the A11 of B will be subtracted from A11 of matrix A. Similarly, B minus A, the A11 of matrix A will be subtracted from the B11 of the matrix B. So simply what we have to do, when the two matrices are given and having the same order, then subtraction of matrix means we have to subtract the corresponding element as per the given condition. For example, if we have given matrix A is equals to, let A is equals to given 2, minus 3, minus 4, 0, minus 2, 3, 4, 0, 1. This is the matrix A of order 3 cross 3. Similarly, let the matrix B is equals to 0, minus 2, minus 3, 4, 3, 2, 0, 1, minus 2. This is also order 3 cross 3. And if you have to find matrix A minus B, that is the subtraction of matrix B from matrix A. Then what we will do? First of all, we will write matrix A as it is, that is 2 minus 3 minus 4, 0 minus 2, 3, 4, 0 and 1. Then put minus and write the matrix B as it is. So matrix B is 0, minus 2, minus 3, 4, 3, 2, 0, 1 and minus 2. So that is A minus B, first step. Now in second step, A minus B will be equals to what we have to do. Since the given matrix A and B both are of the same order of order 3 cross 3, therefore the subtraction, how we will do? We will subtract the corresponding element, that is A11 of A is 2 and the A11 of matrix B is 0, so 2 minus 0, then minus 3 minus, minus of minus will be this element we have to subtract, so minus of, that is minus 2, then minus 4, minus we have to do, so minus of minus 3, then 0 minus 4, then minus 2, minus 3, then 3 minus 2, then 4 minus 0, then 0 minus 1, then 1 minus of minus 2. So what we have to do? Simply we have to subtract the corresponding element and we have to put the minus sign between those elements. So see, 2 minus 0, minus 3, minus of minus 2, because this A12 is already negative. Similarly, minus 4, minus of minus 3, then 0 minus 2, minus 2 minus 3, 3 minus 2, and 4 minus 0, 0 minus 1, and 1 minus of minus 2. So, this is the subtraction of matrix B from A. Now, the resultant matrix will be 2 minus 0, that is 2, minus 3 plus 2, minus 3 plus 2, minus 1, minus 4 plus 3, minus 1, then 0 minus 4, minus 4, minus 2 minus 3, that is minus 5, 3 minus 2, that is 1, then 4 minus 0 is 4, 0 minus 1, that is equals to minus 1, and 1 minus or minus 2, that is 1 plus 2, that is 3. So this is the resultant matrix of the same order 3 cross 3 and it is represented by matrix A minus B. So this is was the solution of matrix A minus B. Similarly, you can subtract A from B also because the order of both the matrix is same. So this was subtraction of two matrices. I think it is the simplest topic. Now the next topic is matrix multiplication, and the matrix multiplication is the most important topic because on the matrix multiplication you will get one question in board exam. So let matrix multiplication. Matrix multiplication, most important topic of this chapter, matrix multiplication. How we will multiply the two given matrix and under what circumstances we will be able to multiply the matrix. So let's, we have given two matrix A having element Aij of order m cross n, and let B be the another matrix having element Bij of order n cross p. The most important thing is when we will able to multiply the two matrix and how we will check whether the given matrix are multiplicable or not. So the first condition, when we will able to multiply that is AB, when we will able to find AB, what is the condition under which we can find AB in the given question. So first of all, what you have to do in the examination, when two matrix are given and if you have to multiply or if you have to find the multiplication of given matrix, then first of all you have to observe the order of given matrix. So the order of first matrix, order is m cross n, and the order of matrix B is n cross p. So one thing you have to remember always, CR means CR rule. This is not a universal rule. By experience I am telling, if two matrices are given, that is matrix A and B, and if we have to find the multiplication of these two matrix, then first of all you have to observe the order of matrix A and B, and then CR rule, that is the number of column in first given matrix, that is the number of column, C stand for column, number of column in the first matrix should be equals to the number of row in second matrix. If the CR rule is satisfied, then we will able to the multiplication of given matrix A with B. That is, this is known as pre-multiplication, and this AB is known as pre-multiplication. Similarly, if we have to find BA, then again see, in the given matrix B, the number of column should be equals to the number of row in the given matrix A. In such circumstances, this is known as post-multiplication. So what we have to do, when we have to multiply the two given matrix, then in the pre-multiplication, the number of column, that is number of column in the first matrix, should be the number of rows in the second matrix, that is your CR, column row rule should be satisfied. And we have to multiply, then we will reverse this rule, that is while multiplying, we will multiply row to the column. Row will be multiplied with the column. So this is called matrix multiplication. Now one example we are taking here to understand how we will multiply the two given matrix and in what manner we will write the multiplication of row with the column. So let one matrix is given, let A be given, let A barabar any matrix 1 minus 2 3. This is the given matrix A, and simply if we have to find the order of the matrix, then this matrix is of order 1 cross 3. That is, number of row in the given matrix is 1 and the number of column in the given matrix are 3. Now, if we have to multiply this matrix A with the another matrix B, then what is the minimum condition to multiply A with B? So, number of column in the first matrix is 3. Therefore, number of rows in the second matrix should be at least 3 and at most 3. So, for example, the second matrix is having element 2, minus 3, 4, 5, 6 and 0. This is the matrix B. Now observe what is the order of matrix. Order of matrix is 3 cross 2. Now first of all we have to check in the given question whether the matrix A is multiplicable with the matrix B. So if we have to find AB, then what we have to check? The number of column, that is CR rule. Very simple. The number of column in the first matrix, that is count the column. Column first, column second, column third. So total number of column is 3. Okay. Now see how many rows in the second matrix. R1, this is R2, this is R3. So number of column equals to number of row. So AB is possible. You have to just take in this way. Now how you will calculate AB? So we will write first A, matrix A, 1, minus 2, 3. Then we will write the matrix B, that is 2, minus 3, 4, 5, 6 and 0. Now while multiplication of A with B, what we will do? We will multiply row with column. So first row, first column, corresponding element will be multiplied and we will write in the row itself. So 1 into 2 plus of minus 2 into minus 3 plus 3 into 4. First row, first column. Then first row, second column, and we will write in the first row itself, 1 into 5 plus minus 2 into 6 plus 3 into 0. So, first row will be multiplied with first column, that will be resultant element in the matrix AB. Then first row will be multiplied with the second column and written in the first row, because row will be multiplied with all the columns. If one column is there, then only one element will be there in the first row. If two columns are there, then there will be two elements in first row in the resultant matrix, and similarly one more column is there, then the multiplication of row with the third column, that will be the third element in first row in the resultant matrix. Now you can calculate what is finally AB. AB will be equals to 1 into 2, 2 and 2 plus 6 plus 12, here 5 minus 12 plus 0. So resultant matrix will be equals to 2 plus 6, 8 plus 12, that is first element will be 20, and second 5 minus 12, that is minus 7. So resultant matrix AB will be of order 1 cross 2, because number of rows was only 1 and column was 2. So it will be of order 1 cross 2. In next class we will discuss the next topic and we will do some more application part of matrix multiplication and its properties. Hope you like this video. All the students are requested, please share, like it and subscribe it. Thank you a lot.